Hey, what's going on, everyone? So today I'm going to make a video on how I make my thumbnails specifically, so that way if anyone wants to make their own stuff and they don't really know what they're doing, then maybe my videos or explanation of whatever I do might help. This is like completely, I guess, customized. Like, you don't have to do it my way. It's like you can do it your own way, basically. Once you see how this all works, you just do stuff your own way. So this is like a Photoshop file that I have saved that I can open up and then just edit from there to make creating a thumbnail easier. So I have a preset to go off of, but this is not what the thumbnail. I'm gonna kind of make one for this video right now as I talk about it. So since I have a preset up, it might be confusing for you at first, since I just open this and it just comes up. So what you would do before this to start making it is you would open up Photoshop, and this would be blank, and then you'd have to hit File, New, and then 1920 by 1080, and then you'd press OK, and then you get this blank white sheet. And then from there, you would start working off of it, and this is what you'd come up with eventually. So I'm gonna start going over how you get to this point. You can see on the side here, I have layers. This layer being the background. This would be like text, so this is the solo, the word solo. And then you can see there are like effects on it. So as an example, to edit text, you can go to a website, which I'll put in the description, to download different fonts, because this font doesn't come with Photoshop. So I'll put that in there for you as well. But basically, so if I wanted to edit the solo, I can click the T for text, hover over solo, click at the end of it, so you can like backspace it and stuff. But this is the color, so like you can edit the color for the text. I have it on this yellow color. And then from there, you could like say highlight it. You could highlight this text and then pick a different font style if you wanted to change this font. You can a shortcut, you can press Control T, which will highlight this word. And then you can hold shift and the corner. It'll help you, like, it'll keep it in the same aspect ratio, and then you can expand or shrink the text. These are just some tips and stuff that you can use for Photoshop if you don't know them already. So, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna create the thumbnail for this video on this tab. Let's see. All right, so at this point in the video, my recording for my voice just disappeared for no reason, so now I had to re-record over top of original recorded stuff. Yeah, so this is the spot that I wanted to clip, so I skipped to it, and then I switched to like free open cam, so you can see the whole picture, and then I got rid of the scoreboard and the nameplates, I think. Yeah, so you just wanna like find the spot you want, and you wanna try and get like the angle and everything that you wanted for it. Just make it how you want. So I'm kind of just, I was just searching for like the exact spot I wanted, and then when I found the image I wanted, I just took a screenshot. Okay, so right here is where I wanted to take my screenshot. So I just go here, and then I press Alt F1 if you're using GeForce Experience for me to take a screenshot. And after you take the screenshot, you can just delete the replay if you don't need it anymore. Alright, so what I'm doing at this point is I'm going back to open up the screenshot that I took. So once you find it in your files, you open it up. And then what I decided to do from here was I was going to select the car, the ball, the boost, and the other car. And what I planned to do with that was copy them and paste them into a new layer. So there's it's the cars and the ball are on top of the background, which is the image itself. And then you can edit the background and the cars and the ball separately from each other. So that's what I'm doing here, is I'm just quick selecting the ball and the cars and the boost. You can in the top left you have like the plus and minus, so minus means like you don't want that piece of the image to be used, and the plus means that's what the part of the image that you want to be used in your selection. Alright, so from this point, I have the duplicate image. So basically, what you want to do from here is once you have it all selected the way you want it, you just copy paste it so you have another image. You can see the second layer on the right-hand side above the background. That's the extra image layer of the car, and the opponent's car, and the boost, and the ball. And then I'm going to add a blur to it. So you go to filter, go down to Gaussian blur, and then I usually use 5 pixels, but you can experiment with that and use whatever you think looks good. You can just mess around with it. But that's what I usually use. So we have the Gaussian blur on the background, and it's not on the car's boost or the ball because those are the images I selected and copied over to a new layer, which is that layer is on top of the background, so you can see it on top of the blurred section. And then I'll merge the layers together to make one layer. And then I'll just use the quick selection tool to select the entire image, and then you can move that image over to the area that you're working on, which I had this new area that I was showing you how to start from scratch. So I was pasting it there as well, and then I had the preset image that I already created a long time ago that I can copy and paste, presets, images, and stuff over to make creating thumbnails easier. So I put it over there too, just to show you how I do it if I'm not starting over. All right, so from this point, I start coming up with the words that I want to use. So I normally have that pre-typed out stuff where I can just edit the text and then resize it and stuff. But since we're doing it from scratch on here, I don't. So I just started showing, like, oh, I'll just type out, how to create Rocket League thumbnails or something like that. So that's what I have here, and then you're going to see me go back over to my other pre-typed up or pre-made thumbnail setup, and I have different like filters and stuff that you can copy and paste over to the new stuff, so you don't have to figure it all out and refine all the settings you were using before. So I'll put those on the screen so you can see what they are, so you can copy and paste them or write them down or whatever if you want to. All right, so this is on the pre-setup image that I normally use, and if you just go to blending options on any of the layers, it'll show you the things that are already used on it. So like the stroke, the shadows and stuff, and there's a check mark on the box if you're using it. So you can see the percentages and levels and all that kind of stuff that I've applied to them. So if you want it to look exactly the way I made it look, then you can do that, or you can mess with the levels and colors and angles and stuff and make it your very, very own custom whatever you want. So basically what I did was I cop you can right click copy the original, so layer style, copy layer style from the preset image that I have, and then you can click right click these layers with the text and click paste layer style and paste it over top of the text you already have typed, and it will just apply all the filters and stuff that you applied on the other one to this one, so you don't have to redo it all, which is the point of saving Photoshop files, so you can you don't have to redo everything every single time you want to do something. You can save presets to use, which makes it way easier. So that's how I did. That's how I made the text look like that so quickly. Just copied and pasted the layer styles over, and then you can just change the colors as you can see here. You can just make whatever color you want. Okay, so what I ended up doing here was I went back to my preset image, and I have an image in there that has presets on it that are for like the glow of like surrounding the cars and balls and the boost. So I opened that up just so you could see what it looks like. I have the eyeball turned off on it, so you can't normally see it, but I turned it on just so you could see what the effects that I was trying to take from it. So I'm gonna copy the layer style of that. But I just showed off the blending options, so if you want to use these effects on an image that you have, you can copy and use them as well. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy the layer style of this car with those glowing effects, and I'm going to paste that layer style onto the other image. What I should say is I accidentally screwed up, so I had to go back to this image where I merged it together, and I had to press Control Alt Z a couple times to unmerge it, and then so I could paste this layer style on top of the other image. You can see there on the right that they're split up again because I had to fix that. So then I just went back into this image and fixed it, and then I didn't like how thick the stroke was on this, so I just went into the where the stroke option is, and I just reduced it a little. And I called that good enough. So after I edited that, I just copied that image, or I merged it back together, and then I copied that whole image, and then I pasted it back over into the other thumbnail so you can see more of what it would look like. You'll see in a second. So we went over here, and then I just deleted that background where I didn't do it right, and then I pasted in the new one where it has the glowing effect. And I think I do the same thing on the other one. So that was pretty much it for this video. The only thing I wanted to say about it that I wasn't able to really comment on was that, like, that orangish border that I was using, the one that you're looking at right now. So there are ways to make borders. I just don't remember how because I made it a long time ago, and when I transferred the file over to this new computer, I didn't have the Photoshop file to edit. I just had the finished image. So There are other videos online that show how to make a border like that. So if you want to learn how to make one of those, you can do that, or I could make one. It's up to you guys. If you really want me to do it, then I can show how to make one, but I'd have to figure it out again. So aside from that, that's basically the end of the video. Just a little thing how I make my thumbnails, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace out.